Welcome to a formal definition of limits. The goals of this video are to give a formal definition of a limit and also to prove a specific limit exists. Let's do a quick review of the idea of a limit informally. The limit as x approaches 3 of f of x exists if, as we approach positive 3, identified by this vertical line, from both the left side and the right side, and we approach the same function value, the limit exists, and the limit is equal to that function value that we're approaching. So from this graph, we can see as we approach positive 3 from the left, we're approaching a function value or a y value of positive 2, and the same is true as we approach from the right. Therefore, this limit is equal to positive 2, even though this function does not exist at x equals 3, as we can see by this whole. Now let's take a look at the formal definition of a limit. If we let f of x be a defined function on an open interval containing c, and it doesn't need to be defined at c as we saw from the previous graph, the limit as x approaches c of f of x equals L means that for every epsilon greater than 0, there exists a delta greater than 0 such that, now remember, absolute value means distance. So the distance between x and c is greater than 0 and less than delta. So delta is a horizontal distance. Then distance between the function and the limit is less than epsilon. So epsilon will be a vertical distance from L. So this means in order to prove a limit exists, we need a relationship between delta and epsilon. So what this is saying is that for any vertical distance epsilon from L, there needs to be a horizontal distance delta so that the distance between x and c is less than delta, such that the distance between f of x and L is less than epsilon. To develop this in a problem, we're actually going to work backwards, but let's take a look at this graphically first. So if we generalize that first graph that we looked at, let 3 on the x-axis equal c, and let 2 on the y-axis equal L, and then let epsilon be this vertical distance here, this interval would be L minus epsilon all the way to L plus epsilon. And if we let delta be this vertical distance here and here, this vertical interval would be C minus delta all the way to C plus delta. And the idea of the formal definition is that if we're given some epsilon that produces a vertical interval around our limit L, there must be some horizontal distance delta such that the inputs into the function in this interval would have to produce outputs in the interval from L plus or minus epsilon. So the key to writing these proofs is to developing a relationship between epsilon and delta. So let's take a look at our first example. We have the limit as x approaches 6 of 1/3 x plus 1 equals 3. Now our function is linear, so we can perform basic substitution to verify this limit is true. But we actually want to prove it. So we need to develop a relationship between epsilon and delta in order to write the proof. So what we're going to do is start with what we want to show, that the absolute value of f of x minus L is less than epsilon, and then we're going to manipulate this absolute value to make it match the absolute value of x minus c. And by doing that, we'll determine the relationship between epsilon and delta. So we'll start with the absolute value of f of x minus L is less than epsilon, and now we'll substitute 1/3 x plus 1 for f of x, and we'll substitute 3 for L. So we'll have the absolute value of 1/3 x plus 1 minus 3 less than epsilon. And now we want to manipulate this so this becomes the absolute value of x minus c, which in this case would be absolute value of x minus 6. So let's first clear the parentheses. We have the absolute value of 1/3 x plus 1 minus 3, that's minus 2. We still have epsilon on the right. Now if we want this to be x instead of 1/3 x, we could multiply both sides of the inequality by 3. So now that we have 3 epsilon, now let's go ahead and distribute this 3 into the absolute value. So 3 times 1/3 x is x, and 3 times 2 is 6, so we have minus 6 less than 3 times epsilon. Now remember, we're trying to show a relationship between epsilon and delta, and notice how the absolute value of x minus c is less than delta, but we've shown that the absolute value of x minus 6 is less than 3 epsilon. So this tells us that we can let 3 epsilon equal delta, and then from here we can write our proof. So to determine the relationship, we kind of worked our way from right to left. Now that we've found the relationship between epsilon and delta, we'll write our proof in the other direction from left to right. So in order to prove this limit, we'll start with 0 less than the absolute value of x minus c less than delta. And now we'll perform the substitution. So we'll have the absolute value of x minus c, but c is 6, less than delta. And now we're going to go ahead and replace delta with 3 epsilon. And now we're going to manipulate this to end up with the absolute value of the quantity 1/3 x plus 1 minus 3 is less than epsilon, which will be the absolute value of f of x minus l less than epsilon. So notice over here we multiplied by 3, so now what we're going to do is factor 3 out of x minus 6. If we factor 3 out, this would be 1/3 x. If we factor a 3 out of 6, that'll be 2. Now we'll go ahead and pull the 3 out of the absolute value. And now I'll go ahead and divide everything by 3. So if we divide this by 3, we're going to have the absolute value of 1/3 x minus 2 is less than epsilon. So you kind of see where we're headed. And now just to make it fit the form of f of x minus l, we know f of x is 1/3 x plus 1, so we'll go ahead and rewrite this as 1/3 x plus 1, but it still has to be minus 2, so we'll have to subtract 3 is less than epsilon. And now we're done because we've shown that 0 is less than the absolute value of this is f of x minus our limit 3 is less than epsilon. So again, to develop this relationship, we worked our way from right to left. And once we found the relationship between epsilon and delta, we worked our way from left to right in order to write the proof. Notice how we started with the absolute value of x minus c is greater than 0 and less than delta. And we showed that if that was true, then the absolute value of f of x minus l was less than epsilon. So there's the proof that our limit is equal to 3.